Hi everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to set up and run HTML and CSS code in Windows 10, as well I will be showing you the necessary extensions that you can install in Visual Studio Code. So let's get started. So just go to Google and type download Visual Studio Code. You will be getting the first link over here as codevisualstudio.com. Just click that. And here you will be having Visual Studio Code for different OS. There is for Windows, Linux and Mac. I am gonna download it for Windows. So I'll just click on this Windows, okay? So download will get automatically started. So it is about 88.8 MB in size. So just be patient. So once the download is complete, just click on open. And you'll be getting like this license agreement. Just click on I accept. You can just scroll down and read it. Next. So this is the location where Visual Studio Code will be installed. So if you want, you can just browse and change the location. I am fine with the default one. Just click on next. And next as well. And here you can like create a desktop icon, and it's always good to have this one. Just check this, okay? Action to Windows Explorer. Yeah, better to give check everything and just click on next and install. Such a simple installation process, okay? Yeah, so once the installation is done, just click on launch Visual Studio Code and click on finish. So this is the first interface that you will be getting after you launch Visual Studio Code. So you can like change the theme. There is light contrast, dark is the standard stuff. So after opening Visual Studio Code, I want you to create a new folder in your system. So just right click in local disk, any of your disk, new folder. I will name it as code and enter it. And in the Visual Studio Code, you'll be having the file option over here. Just click file. You'll be having the open folder and go to the folder that you've created right now. So it's code, click it and click on select folder. Okay, yeah, just click on trust. So we'll be getting the code folder over here, which is now empty. So now we will be creating the HTML as well as the CSS files. So I'll just right click. So I'll just name it as mypro.html. And you'll be getting the HTML file. And if I just now right click again, I'll just click styles.css. So this is a way like you can create HTML and CSS files at first. So first let me go with the extensions that are needed. So just click on this, you'll be having the extensions over here, click it. And here you need to install the live server extension first. So it's going to be live server. You'll be having this live server, really important thing, because like whenever you create or make any changes in your HTML file, you need to go and refresh it again in the browser. But using this live server, that can be avoided and it automatically gets refreshed, okay? So that's the live server at first. And next one is going to be the prettier. Prettier. Yeah, this is that extension. You'll be having this prettier code formatter. So it basically formats our code. So this is also like super useful. Just click on install. So I think these two extensions are pretty much enough. I'm having live server, prettier code, and rest are all like auto formatted, because so here you can see that I'm having HTML over here and I'm having CSS like auto formatted, and the intelligence automatically works in Visual Studio Code. So that's the best thing about this IDE. So once you're done with that, we will need to change the size of our code. So here you can see it, the text size is so small. So for changing the text size, you'll be having this settings icon over here, or it's called as manage. Click that, you'll be having settings. And in the settings, you'll be having the control, the font size in pixels. I will go with 30. So you can just give whatever the size you want and hit enter. Yeah. So I will now go to style. So here you can see, right, the text size has now increased by drastically. So save it. And after the text size, next one is going to be the theme. So now it is like a black color theme. So I will go with manage the same icon, and here you will be having the color theme. Click that. So we are having like these many color themes available. So you can see that you can just select it out again. So I will go with, yeah, so you can just like have a preview of that, each and every color theme that is available. So this is a default one. I will go with the default. You can like have the preferred choice of your own, okay? I'll just go with this one, okay? The default one itself. So another important tip that I want to show you in HTML is that the use of this automatic or default code. So for this, you need to just type the exclamatory mark or the exclamation symbol. So shift and press the one key, okay? The exclamation symbol. So if you press that, you'll be having this emmet abbreviation, okay? You'll be having the option like this. And if you just now hit enter, you'll be getting this boilerplate code automatically generated. So everything is like automatically created for you by default. And if you need to just have some body content, so I'll just go with H1. So here you can see, right, everything is intelligence. Automatically I'm getting all the tags that are starting with the letter H. So this is how it works. I'll go with H1, automatically closes as well. I will go with hello world like that. Yeah. So after entering the necessary code, we need to view this in the output, right? We need to see the output, what this code does. So what's the normal way of doing it? We will be going to the folder where we have our HTML file, which is code, and we will just double click on it. So this will basically open it in the browser. But whenever I make any change, so now I'm just like, hello world, I'm adding D like this, and I'm saving it now. But in the output, it won't change. We need to like refresh it again. So then only it changes. So what if I don't want to refresh it? Okay, so you don't, okay. For that, we will be using the live server, the extension that we had installed earlier, this one, okay. So now I will just now close my browser completely, okay. So once you are done installing live server, you'll be having this option called as go live, okay. You'll be having like click to run live server. Just click that, go live, and just click on allow access or something, yeah. So now the server is on. So here you can see, right, it's like the local host. The server is on our local host, so it's running locally. So if I make any changes and save in my Visual Studio Code, the changes will be getting automatically reflected in my browser. I don't need to like click on refresh multiple times even after making a simple change. So I will go with, rather than saying hello world, I will go with hello everyone like that, and I'm just saving it in my Visual Studio Code. I'm saving it, and if I go to my browser, so here you can see, right, I didn't refresh it. The changes are getting automatically reflected in my browser if I make any in my Visual Studio Code. So this is the purpose of this particular live server. It's super, super useful. And rest, it's fine. We have the auto intelligence. So here you can see, right, for all the tags, we will be having the intelligence working. So iframe, image. So the intelligence is fine. No worries about that. So here you can see, right, all the tags will be coming. And now let's see about some CSS. So let's add and check some CSS. So I'll go with styles, and I will have ID tag as heading. So for those who don't know what is ID, ID tag is used to uniquely refer a particular tag or element in HTML. So if I give ID as heading, this refers to this particular H1 tag. So with the help of this ID, we can add styles and change any properties for this text or the heading H1. So I hope that made sense. So ID, I will giving it as heading. So I'm just saving it now, and I will go to my styles.css. So in my case, both are present in the same folder. It's always good to have in the same folder. So I'm going in styles. So for ID, we will be referencing it with hashtag, and we need to type heading, curly bracket, and here we need to add any changes that we want. So I will just go with color at first. So it's going to be, so everything has autocomplete over here. Intelligence works by default. So that's the best thing. So I'll go with color. And here you can see, right, so many colors, varieties are displayed. I will go with blue. And if I just now save it, And after saving it, I need to reference this particular CSS file in my .html file. So for that, just within the head tag, okay, you need to add this particular link tag. I hope you know these things. Link, we'll be having that link rel stylesheet link. And after that, we'll be having rel, yeah, equal to, we need to specify the file type, which is stylesheet, yeah, stylesheet, be careful with the spelling. And after that, we'll be using the href for referencing. And inside that, we need to like pass the name of this file, which is styles.css in my case, and just close. Okay, doesn't have a closing tag like a slash, it is just normal open and close angular brackets. So I'm just now saving it. So if everything goes well, we need to have a blue color hello everyone in our browser. So here you can see, right, I'm having a blue color hello everyone. So yeah, pretty much simple, guys. Only these two for like, what do you call these two extensions. And everything is just taken care by Visual Studio Code. And don't forget about this auto, like I told you, right, the MUT abbreviation for generating boilerplate code. It's super helpful. So I think you would have found this video useful. Mine is a programming channel. I have done many tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check them. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.